Good day. How the hunk are you? Welcome to Roverland. This is your friend Dano, and I got an unboxing for you. Yeah, we're going to do this on an unboxing Saturday. I can't believe this. This is awesome. This is grand. This is glorious. First off, I just got to tell you where I got this from. Got this from my new friend, Jeremy. And he has got a YouTube channel, Calm and Collected. Yes. The story is, Jeremy, he is from Westminsterland City, PA. I think that's Westminsterland City, PA. Well, anyway, PA, that's Pennsylvania. So he's from Pennsylvania. Anyway, how I got a hold of Jeremy was he did a very, very good. Go over to his YouTube channel, Calm and Collected. Go over there. Check that out. He did a video interview with my friend, Champion DJK, at Champion DJK. Champion DJK has a YouTube channel, obviously. He's part of the Fox Valley Diecast Club that I'm part of and go to all the time. We've probably seen some club meet stuff, unboxing stuff. So check that out. So anyway, they did an awesome review. Dave told me about it. I went and checked it out. Excellent work by Jeremy, by the way. Hats off to him and his work. All right, so in doing so, I checked out Jeremy's other videos, and he does model reviews and things like that. And one of the things he does model reviews on is Jurassic Park, Jurassic World, which you guys all know I love movies. You know, the dude, Big Lebowski, Ace Ventura, Jurassic Park. Those are kind of like my big loves of movies. So anyway, I got a hold of him from his YouTube channel. We started talking back and forth, and he had some Jurassic Park stuff that I did not have that he was willing to get rid of and sell. So, that's right. He said he put a box inside a box. That's great, because this is carded stuff here, too. So, all right, we're going to get the... I have a big collection of Jurassic Park stuff. Sorry, I got to throw that box somewhere. Big collection of Jurassic Park stuff. And the last... I was missing stuff. And... we'll see what all I got to finish my collection with. And so anyway, thank you very much, Jeremy. This is awesome. I hope people see this and then go see your channel, because you do excellent work, man. I wish I was as good and had the equipment as you have got. Oh, just excellent work. So we got some bag stuff here. Let's take a look at some of the bag stuff. Loose stuff, and like I say, I collect, I was trying, this is one of the, let me back up a little bit. Well, I'll talk while I'm showing this stuff off. One of the reasons I don't, collect, a lot of stuff, other than Land Rovers is because, I don't know, I don't know if it's a mental issue or what. But a lot of times I can't complete I'm a completist. I like to have the whole complete set of things, okay? And so if I go for a certain series or something like that from Matchbox or Hot Wheels or anybody, I'd like to get the complete set. If I like it, I want the whole thing. Well, in Wisconsin, that's where I'm from, it's very, very hard to get Land Rover or diecast things, and especially you know, complete sets. And so, you know, it's just very frustrating. And so I, to save my sanity, I don't collect a lot of things. I know, like, Greenlight has got some movie stuff, and I think I'm missing some stuff from Jurassic, or from the Ace Ventura stuff, you know, and it just bugs me, you know. I want to, you know. So anyway, oh, here, I don't think I had this one. Those other ones I've had. So anyway, so yeah, so I, the last series that Jurassic Park or Matchbox put out about Jurassic Park, I think was about the time Corona hit, and I just did not get the last stuff, and it was very scarce on eBay, and now it's like a couple years old, so now it's very, very expensive. I think I've got this bugger here. And this actually is a fantasy vehicle that was never in the movies, but is very, very cool vehicle. Here's one I'm really sure I don't have. And I don't mind this loose stuff because I have a big collection of loose stuff. Yes, I don't have this one. And yeah, I think there's a clean version and this dirty version. What do they call this? InGen 4x4. Yeah, this is awesome. This is awesome. And so a lot of this stuff I just did not have. And, you know, I collect loose and carded because I'm so narrow-minded on my stuff. So there we go. Awesome. Awesome already. Awesome. Thank you very much, Jeremy. Wow, this is great. This is great. All right. So actually, I'm going to turn this around because the best stuff I'm going to save to last. How's that? Ha, ha, ha. All right. Oh, yeah. So here we go. So, yes, this is it. This is the one, this series, the red card, I call it red card series, is the series that I don't have. And I believe there was a clean version and a dirty version. And like I say, for whatever reason, towards the end of the series, this is the last series that was put out, 2019. And for whatever reason, this is like a Walmart exclusive kind of that I know of. For whatever reason, I just couldn't get the stuff. And it just irks me. So anyway, so he had some stuff. I'm not going to tell you the price, but he did me a very, very good deal. He sold off his duplicates and stuff like that he didn't need or want. And just totally cool. So two different motorcycles there. These are the clean versions. They're not this here. I just found out that this motorcycle here has got some variations. The handlebars are light gray on some. There is a dirty version. So I was just like, wow. So let's see. I don't know. I don't know if I have those in here. All right, here we go. And some of these are repeats as far as the models. I think this is a little bit lighter. Boy, I was just messing with my Jurassic Park stuff the other day, and you could barely see through that canopy. So there is a little bit lighter one. Awesome, awesome. I like that. Sorry for the glare. This, I do have one of these, and now I have another loose. I like to keep the loose ones as a pair, so you can, you know, store them and show them forward and backwards. So this is just great. This is great. You know what? I don't think I have this one. This is the green one. The first one was, a gray color. And so now here's the green one. But once again, on this different card. Oh, yeah, here we go. Here is the dirty version. He's in the package backwards, isn't he? Yeah, he's in the package backwards. Matchbox points to the left. Hot Wheels points to the right. Yeah, I think that's not open. Yeah, that's not open. I'm going to set that aside and double check that. See how they're... Yeah. Anyway, awesome, awesome. Well, here's another one. Okay, so here's the other one. That's and this is they call that the Textron Tiger. Very cool. Fantasy casting, but very cool. I got to move right along. We're getting right along here, and I still haven't got to the cool stuff. All right, here's... I didn't have these. These have got the shiny green chrome green wheels on it. And yeah, open, more open and stuff like that. That is awesome. So I got two of those. Awesome there. That is awesome. I like that. All right, now we get into some of the standard stuff. This is the Jeeps. Yep. These are the Jeep Wranglers. Roll bar one. I don't even know if I have this one. That is awesome. Here is the one I do have. I was able to pick up some of these, but this was not on the red card. The last time this came out wasn't on the red card. You know, it was just on the regular card. Matter of fact, I thought this was the same one, but this is the roll bar one. So they just recently they've put out this again. I just bought these not too long ago. I bought two of them, and I bought one with like this, but it was on the regular card. I think it was damaged because I opened it up. But yeah, they're still putting stuff out, but it's in the regular type lineup. So yeah, awesome. Okay, here's another one of the canopies. Newman's car, kind of like, yeah. Here you go. Here's the dirty Jeep. I love that. I love that. All right, here is another motorcycle. Yep, the Scrambler. I set that aside. Awesome. Yeah, any of these duplicates, I am not mad about or upset about or whatnot. So here we go. So this is the red card. I got to make this quick now, get to the good stuff, and I got to hurry right along. So here's the Ford Explorer on the red card. Now here's a little bit different one. A Jurassic World with the Ford Explorer. This is the 05. This is the 05 as well. But very, very kind of cool. A little bit different packaging and all that. That is awesome. I love it. All right, here's the ones that are very exclusive and very hard to find. And wow, he gave me a good deal on these. I never knew that these existed. But these are the Explorers that are crushed, that are stepped on by the T-Rex from the first movie. So awesome, awesome, awesome. This is great. Awesome. Yes, 2019 these came out. So that's 2 years ago already, right? So very, very kind of cool. Thank you once again, Jeremy. This is awesome stuff. I hope you guys enjoy this. I know it's not Land Rover stuff, but it's diecast stuff, and this is one of my favorite stuff. I guess why I put this on the channel and I share it with you is because someday Roverland will customize a Discovery to mimic this Jurassic Park vehicle. That's right. I want to make the whole thing, not Mercedes, but Land Rover. So that's my goal. In the future. If you want to see that, keep supporting the channel, all right? All right, this is your friend Dano. Thank you for sticking around. Long unboxing Saturday. I'm out of here. Remember, slow traffic, keep right, and have a great Rover Day!